sorry to say, there are no microphones, so I know you'll hear me, but could anyone who's speaking back please speak up, knowing that there's no microphones at all in the room. Can I then ask for apologies? I've been asked to record Steve Fowkes if he doesn't make it back from Manchester. Angie Davies has just taken ill outside, she's gone home. And the other one is Bill Davies, who we are expecting, and sort of waiting to see him in terms of the vote. But I think, apart from that, I think everybody from the member side is here. The minutes of the last meeting, which we held on the 3rd of November, someone declares a true record. Thank you, Paul. Second in five. Okay, so are there any matters arising from those minutes? Is everybody happy with the minutes? Right, and then declarations of interest. Has anybody got any declarations of interest for tonight? No again? Right. Then I'll just go on to say, today's committee is a little bit different because we're so close to the last one. We are feeding back on some of the excellent work carried out last year in Birkenhead. Thank you for the lovely surplus food buffet provided by Feeding Birkenhead's food hubs. Thank you to Mark from First Year for coming and providing much of our food to the food hubs and to the food hubs for the great work that they do, which we'll come to later. First Year is an important partner for our food hubs, and please do contact Mark for more details of what First Year do and to become a member. Carl Rooney from Big Local will now update us on the successful In Bloom projects last year. Over to you, Carl.
Generally, the environment, we all know, isn't the top priority during austerity. But this project brought people together, and that's what we're going to talk about now. The challenge was set to us as part of 15 areas to, with the support of the constituency group, to make changes to the local environment as a nicer place to make it a nicer place to live, to share resources, promote ideas and get things done, prior to entering into the North Western Bloom competition. For this, we'll be sure some of the first times that they've ever done such a thing. It wasn't just about hanging baskets, it was about creating a platform for partnership working, encouraging local volunteers to take ownership over their part in the community. It made business sense as well, areas looked better, pride was developed, people, and it also improved people's health and well-being. That is a proven fact. The project also wanted to take an intergenerational project aspect, linking schools to the environment with the support of the Eco Schools Officer, planting the early seeds to take care of their community. The project made areas more inviting, inspired people within local businesses who could see the economic benefits to more attractive retail areas. So what difference did it actually make? Grot to hot, I think, I've put on the slide, and I think you can probably see by some of the pictures that that is the case. I'm not going to show you lots of pictures of this here this evening, raise a couple of examples. But what about the people of Birkenhead? What did they say in their own words? Making things look brilliant, but what is the difference that it made to them? This is the best the area has looked in over 30 years. I'm proud to show people where I live. That was Steve from Bidston St. James Residence and told us. What about the people coming to our area? I used to cycle through parts of Birkenhead with friends who lived to the road many years ago. also, what about some of the people that took part in the project in their own words? John, can you stand up here tonight to show everyone your lovely trophy?
However, we wanted to support our partners wherever a council, where possible, and entered into the competition with good faith, and I'm so proud that we did. With a small budget, we've put lots of commitment, enthusiastic residents and team members, we were able to win three awards. The tenants of Ilchester Road, Bidston Rise and James Brook Close joined forces to spruce up the Bidston area through gardening and growing their own produce. Ilchester Road and Bidston Rise were awarded the Level 3 for Advancing Neighbourhoods, and James Brook Close received Level 4 status for a Thriving Neighbourhood Award. Jean McIntosh, Chair of Bidston Rise Tenants Association, and the community worked with community-based Flourish from Woodchurch, and they held a hanging basket workshop in the summer. This was so more houses on the estate could have a splash of colour to add to the many gardens that had already prepared for the Bidston and Bloom judging. Jean and tenants painted up the upcycled timber benches and planted flowers and trees provided by Magenta Living. It was just fabulous to see the people of all ages coming together. With the help of some of my team, they cleaned up the streets and opened spaces ready for judging day. It was made extra special too, as they erected a memorial plaque on the bench to remember their special friend and neighbour, Rachel Drinkwater, a young mum of three who sadly passed away suddenly. And she was a huge part of the Bidston Rise community. Rachel will be proud to be an RHS winner. She will always be remembered. Ilchester neighbourhood, which includes Buckaloo Street, had keen gardeners, Tia, aged 11, who encouraged other young gardeners to follow suit and make their small gardens into fairy and elf dens with lots of ornaments, flowers and pots. The RHS judge was really impressed with Arthur Whitehead's garden too in Buckaloo Street. Arthur was our very first street champion. He had turned his tiny yard into the most amazing colourful oasis. He had walls of fencing greenery with bird baths, waterfalls and masses of flowers on three levels. It was truly breathtaking. Sadly, Arthur was taken from us too, suffering a short illness, and he never got to see his fabulous award. Again, we will never forget what he did for his neighbours in that neighbourhood. A memorial has been prepared by Magenta Living for Solway Park in his memory this spring. James Brook Close won the Thriving Neighbourhood Award. This was the work that our tenants and private tenants too from Patton Street carried out with our help to a strip of land that was at the back of their homes. Once an unadopted rock spot full of fly tipping and graffiti, it was a no-go zone for tenants as it was dangerous. Children couldn't play in it. Now it's an amazing safe environment for all to enjoy. There are raised beds with fruit trees, veg and lots of grasses and flowers. I was so pleased that the RHS judge wanted to spend so much of his time in our neighbourhoods. I feel it made such a long-lasting impression on him, as our residents are on such very little incomes, but somehow still manage to turn grey areas into such fabulous green thriving ones. He was obviously impressed with all of the places he visited in Birkenhead, Oxton Village, Bidston, etc. But certainly our tenants and their stories and some of the our recognised deprived neighbourhoods left lasting memories and warmed his heart. We've actually seen a noticeable reduction in graffiti in Fly Tipping 2, which is promising. This is just what we want, as it demonstrates that partnership working can really have an impact on behaviours and attitudes towards looking after the local environment. The high bar has been set in 2016, but the residents are already talking about this year's competition and how they can raise the bar even higher. It's going to be another challenge, but we're up for it, and so are our fabulous tenants.
Say a special thank you to all the funders and partners involved. It's been a fantastic project to be involved with. We did it, partnership working at its best. Back to basics. Thank you.
Thank you, John. And now I'll hand over to Jo.
We have done 21 community action days last year, right across Birkenhead, and they involved a lot of the partners that are here today, the fire service, the police, the ASB team, the environmental team, the recycling team, the healthy homes team, and probably others that I've missed out, but we all got together and addressed and focused our activities in certain neighbourhoods, and they've been very, very successful. The high profile, the councillors attend them, and a lot of the residents have been really impressed by the focused approach to the local problems in their area. We've had 77 skips used at each between all of those 21 community cleanup days, and we've had 100 tons of rubbish removed. Magenta Living, LHT, BIFA, Probation Service, some of the other partners, and a special thanks to all the partners for putting their time and resources into these days, because they have been very successful. The fire service, and I know Steve Gavison's here somewhere, provided a unit to each of those cleanup days and did a lot of smoke alarm assessments and fitting smoke alarms. The police came to all of them, did door knocking, and very supportive of residents in those areas, as was Mike Holbrook as well, who's here, brought the contactor bus and looked at some of the ASB issues going on in those particular areas. So they've been very, very successful, taking away fly tipping, tidying up alleyways, and also supporting the residents with a range of other issues. Some examples of the cleanup days are Rodney Street, the Nottingham Estate, Harrowby Road, Beechwood in different areas, North Birkenhead in a lot of the areas, including the avenues, Townsend Street, and quite a few areas in Rock Ferry. So just want to say thanks to all the partners for that, and also ask Ruth and Cllr Ann if they would mind telling us a few, giving us a bit of detail about what happened on the Nottingham Estate when they decided that they'd like to see a cleanup day in their area.
Just at the beginning of December, we done a big cleanup involved all the children on the estate, two schools that are based actually on the estate. And with the help of the council, we went right around, cleaned everywhere up, cleaned all the streets. And now we found that the children themselves are actually noticing the rubbish and what they cleaned up. So if we've gained anything, we've gained the children now looking after the area. So it's been positive, really, hasn't it?
Started off with some underpinning financial support from the Birkenhead Constituency Committee to support people in need in our area, facilitated by the constituency team to share resources, ideas and come together to signpost those in need to prevent duplication and come together and provide hampers for people in our area. So who took part? Four primary areas took part in the hamper scheme: Rock Ferry, Central Birkenhead, North Birkenhead, Beechwood and Valentine. I've also been advised by Trammy Rolls as well, so we apologise on that one. Each one was given the freedom to wear as they see fit. People in the communities know people in their communities, and that was the best way forward. So how did we work in the Beechwood and Valentine area? We wanted to ensure that we targeted those in need, and we set up a specific paper-based referral mechanism. It was one of the key local things that we wanted to bring in place, using key local organisations from housing associations to churches, non-profit groups to schools, so only those working with people in need and knew that those individuals were in need could be referred. This wasn't a chance to get a hamper for anybody who knew or a friend at the end of the road. These forms also recorded the important details of why people were in need, helping us to tailor any future projects that we were moving forward. We used the local and national research about food donations, negotiating what the contents could be of those hampers against the cost and feasibility of the items for local residents. We looked externally for partners to help make the scheme happen. Donations from big business such as Princes to local organisations like Liverpool Housing Trust for the delivery element of the project. And what did the hampers contain? Staple foods that people use on a day-to-day, tea, coffee, bread and milk. Foods based around healthy, easy-to-cook recipes that allow for a balanced diet on multiple days, including elements of the recommended five a day. Some luxuries were there as well, such as cheese and biscuits. It was Christmas, and that was an important part of the advent of the hampers. Whilst being fed is vitally important, personal hygiene cannot be forgotten about. We included these items also, and these are the simple things that the research said are often forgotten but can make the biggest difference to people. And that's not it. The Birkenhead constituency booklet contained information that could be kept by residents and read on topics such as welfare advice, debt, and getting involved in your local community. We also simply said, Merry Christmas, a small touch, but an important one. But what difference did it make to the people in need? The relief on the doorstep in delivering the hampers was palpable. People cried and hugged us when they gave them to residents. People felt part of the community again, sense that somebody does actually care out there. People wrote cards, came in to see us and expressed how much of a difference they had made and the gratitude that they wanted to give to us. I'm going to hand you over to Stephen now, who's going to talk about the quantifying impact of the project.
Just before talking about social value, I just thought I'd cover it, just explain. So LHD use it as a basis for to see the impact, to compare the different projects we do, and to see which may be most effective. So our general aim is usually 1 to 8. So this is far above the return that we receive.
Shouldn't be underestimated. The seed funding that has enabled us to go and secure funding elsewhere, as they can see the committee's priority to improve the lives of residents and demonstrate the importance by financially supporting the project, however small. The above formula has made a massive difference, and our recommendation is that to make things happen in Birkenhead in the future, it's one formula that should not be altered. Final words are widely spoken by a recipient of one of the hamlet schemes who sent us a card. It reads, "Thank you so much for me being nominated for a Christmas hamper. I was stunned at the door. With lots to pay out at Christmas, glasses that fall off me, it was a very welcome surprise. Most of all, comfort in knowing that people do care. Have a good Christmas. These are just some of, again, the partners and funders involved in the project that we'd like to thank you, say a special thank you and for your involvement. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much indeed, Carl. And obviously there are a few other people. I'd just like to say a couple of words, please, from the other food hubs. So can I ask first, Anna Varnish, St James's.
Yeah, hi, evening everybody. Just like to reiterate what Carl said really about great thanks, but just to take this opportunity to celebrate again tonight, because this year is 10 years since North Birkenhead Development Trust started its summer programme, and the work that we've been doing throughout those 10 years, and food has been a fundamental part of this programme, with the focus on being young people developing independence around cooking, sampling new flavours and textures. But just to look at 2016 in particular, and we provided over 1,200 holiday meals and distributed countless boxes of cereal and drugs through Kids Church, as well as Fair Share. Over 812 after school meals, because our provision is not just holiday time, we run term time as well. Over 960 meals to adults with no fixed abode through our hot food hub. And 41 families have learned new cooking skills with us during the last year. Plus, we've had a whole range of community events, which you'll be able to read in the report, from everything from plate bringing, sharing meals, to full buffets, big lunches, afternoon teas, coffee mornings, and much more. In addition, we've also provided cooking for independent living training to over 50 adults with learning difficulties during the last year, and had the pleasure of delivering those at the in Livingston Street. By the end of this year, over 60 residents have also gained a level 2 food hygiene qualification with us, as well as nutrition and allergy awareness qualifications, supporting adults back into work. Fair Share continues to provide products for our cafe, and we've had a great relationship with Fair Share for over 5 years now. And we use the products from Fair Share for our cafe, for our events, for the work we do with young people, and for sale through the social supermarket. We've also been delighted to work with some leading carvery houses and support agencies to provide access to families that may not otherwise have these opportunities. Our work extends beyond food, and as you have read in the report, we were delighted to be able to work with partners in Birkenhead through the Improving Life Chances Consortia to provide a warm homes event last Friday, and we had over 60 residents who received support through that event. As well as enable professionals to network and equip themselves with the knowledge and skills that they may need to support our local families. And thanks also go to Magenta Living, MD Insurance, Money for Your Motors, Bidston Pub, McEwen Wallace, CPL Training and Tesco Bidston for help with our work in the last few months of last year. I'd also like to reiterate what Carl said. We're very grateful for the support of Birkenhead Constituency in funding the activities we've undertaken this year. Without the support, we would not have been able to produce the varied programme we've had, and the funding that you pledged to us was vital to make sure this continues into 2017 and beyond. Thank you.
Thank you.
Further business support and investment into the area and into the projects, along with three of the large housing associations now that we're starting to link with a lot more and work with. Obviously we did the In Bloom as well. We're launching our new look social supermarket in March of this year, thanks to the support of the constituency to get that started, which will hopefully help us make our food and Birkenhead work sustainable and not grand. Reliable. We've intercepted 34 tons of food.